Hello there. Welcome to this video. Let's see how to add and fully customize 2D text and titles with Vegas Pro 14. Leave us comments in this video to improve our next guides for Vegas Pro 14. To add text inside your project, you have to use the Media Generators window right above. If you have it closed, you can open it by going to View, Window, and then to Media Generators. This window collects several ready templates, such as colored backgrounds, noise, credit rolls, and titles. As you can see, you have three different kinds of titles you can add that we will see through this video. Once you choose the title, for example, the legacy text, all its ready templates will show on the right. Then, just drag and drop on the timeline to create a new text clip that uses the same template chosen. Also, the Video Media Generators window opens, which is used to fully edit your text just added. You can open this window anytime by clicking on the Generated Media icon on the clip itself. Before going on editing text, make sure to place the text clip in the right way. This is contained inside a video track and behaves like any other clip that you can move and stretch as you like. But if you want this text to be shown above any picture or video, you must place the text clip on a video track that is higher in the track order. Any text inside Vegas Pro is made by two main components, the title itself and its background. When there is full transparency on the background, it is shown by a checkerboard. Let's see the kind of text you have and how to fully customize your text. Legacy text is a very simple and basic template, perfect to add fast text that does not need special effects or animations. Inside the Video Media Generators, you can use several tabs to edit your legacy text, while you can check how the title changes by looking at the main preview. Just make sure to have your playhead placed on the text clip. Use the Edit tab to change the main text properties such as font style, size, family, and distribution. You will always edit the whole text content unless you select part of it. Under Placement, you can move the text where you like most. Click and drag it, or use the X and Y coordinates. Under Properties, you can improve the text appearance, such as the text color, the overall background color, or Advanced Text Properties below. To change colors, you can directly click on the color mixer or regulate each of the RGB or the HSL channels. On the left, use the vertical bar to regulate the transparency level of the color. Below, you can change the color model to use between RGB or HSL, or use the eyedropper to pick the color you need directly from your screen. Just remember that the frame size above not only sets the resolution of your text clip, but also its background coverage. Under Text Properties, use Tracking to regulate the distance between each letter, Scaling to adjust the text size, and Leading to regulate the distance between each of the new lines inside the text. Under the Effects tab, you can apply advanced effects to make the text appearance cooler. Outline adds some outer glow with the color and the feather and width values applied. Shadows drops shadow with a fixed color, and feather with a distance fixed by both X and Y offsets. Deformation changes the text appearance depending on the type and on the amount value. You can enable or disable each effect to check how these have changed the text appearance. If you need to import animated text, you can use the Titles and Text templates. This shows a different Media Generators interface, but indeed it shares the same text property seen for the legacy text, such as the main text properties on top, the text color, the scaling through scale, and location to drag and move the text where you like. More below, you can adjust the text background and add any outline and shadow effect. Furthermore, you can add special animations under Animation that will last as much as your text clip is in time. However, if you stretch or shorten the text clip, you will just change the length, but not its animation length as well. So, in order to keep the text clip and animation synchronized, remember to always time stretch the text clip by stretching its edges while holding Control down. You can also reverse the text animation. Just right-click on the text clip and go to Reverse. Remember that you must disable the reverse effect if you want to edit the text content in the future. The most advanced piece of text inside Vegas Pro 14 is the ProType Titler. This is a more advanced kind of title with respect to the legacy text one. Its Media Generators window shows, on the left, all the text properties, and on the right, a local preview where text is shown. Here, text is composed by two main parts, the text content and the text block that contains it. If you click on the text on the preview, you will work on the text block. Move the text by clicking and dragging it, and scale it by dragging its corner nodes. Use Lock Aspect to lock or unlock the text block aspect ratio. To rotate text, just hover over the central circle and click and drag. The text will rotate around its center that you can move anywhere if you need. On the left, you can also add any gradient color, blur, glow, or shadow under the Effect tab, or regulate the tracking and the line spacing inside the Layout tab. To edit the text content instead, double-click on the text and change all the basic text properties under the Text tab, and the text appearance such as color, stroke, and background under the Style tab. All these modifications are applied on the selected text only. When you finish editing the text content, just press the Escape key. Even more, you can personalize each single word or letter by using Navigate to Child above. This allows you to move, scale, and rotate each single part of your text. For example, if you have text that includes more than a single word, you can click once on Navigate to Child to regulate each single word, and click once again to manage each single letter. Use Navigate to Parent to go back to the hierarchy. These are the three different title templates you can use inside Vegas. You can also add credits by using the Credit Roll template. Check out our video dedicated to credit rolls to know how to add and use them. Even more, inside Vegas Pro, you can also make 2D text and titles that do change their appearance in time by using objects called keyframes. Keyframes are special markers that are added inside a local timeline inside the text itself at the bottom of the Media Generators window. These markers do save the text appearance on the instant of time they are placed, so that when you go from one keyframe to the following one in time, you will go from the text appearance of the first keyframe to the changed appearance on the second one. This actually creates an animation on the text itself. Keyframes can be added in different ways, depending on the kind of text. For example, inside the legacy text, you can click on Animate below to open the local timeline and start adding keyframes. In the Titles and Text interface, you can click on the clock icon next to each text property. Inside the ProType Titler, you can click on the spiral icon next to each property. No matter what kind of text template, the way to edit and manage the keyframes is identical. When you enable the keyframes, you will get one keyframe at the beginning of the local timeline by default. That saves the text appearance you start from. But to make the text change in time, you need at least two keyframes. So, if you move the marker in another instant of time and change the text properties, a new keyframe is added automatically, saving your last modifications. Have a look at the preview to check and adjust the animation between the two keyframes. Click and drag the keyframes to move them in time. The more these are put closer, the shorter the transition will be. To delete a keyframe instead, place the playhead there, right-click, and go to Delete. Whereas to change the text appearance saved by a keyframe, place the playhead there and change again the text properties with the media generator. Be careful of what shows the local timeline. When you apply keyframes on the legacy text, you will have just one row that includes any text property. On the titles and text and the ProType Titler, you will have one row for each single text property. In this case, the keyframe saves the changes applied on the property it is referred to. Thanks for watching this video. Watch our full guide to discover other advanced features inside Vegas Pro 14.